Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to find the sum of odd digits of a number in Python. So let's get started. So first we'll be getting the number n, which is the number that we are going to find the sum of odd digits from the user. So just have a int of input over here, and don't forget to add input. If you miss this, it will be of type string, but we need a number. Okay, so add int over there. So after getting the number from the user, we will be performing three simple steps. Okay, so first step is going to be extracting the last digit from the number. Okay, extracting the last digit from a number. So can imagine our number to be 1 2 3 4. We need to find a way to extract the last digit, which is 4. And if the number is 1 2 3, we need to extract the last digit 3 from it. And this is the first step. And the second step that we are going to do is check if that number is odd and find sum. Okay, because this is not a sum of every digit, we need to check if the number is odd number, and then we need to find. For example, imagine our number to be same 1 2 3 4, and first we will be extracting number 4 from this number, and we will need to check that this number is odd or even. If this number is not an odd number, we need to just neglect this. And the final step that we will be doing is removing the last digit from our number. So I'll just go with remove last digit. So during the first iteration inside a while loop, we'll be using a while loop to do the entire thing. Okay, so the last step inside our while loop is removing the last digit. So if you have a number as 1 2 3 4, we will be just removing the last digit, and we'll just assign it to that number itself. And in the next iteration, our number will be 1 2 3, and after that our number will be 12, and after that our number will be 12 here also, and it will be 1, and it will be 1, and at the end our number will be basically 0. And when our number becomes 0, we will be having the sum of odd digits. Okay, so don't worry, let me just now code and explain you what I'm going to do. So these are the steps. Okay, these are going to be the steps, and we will be just following the steps. So let's begin with the while loop. So as I told you, I'll be having a while loop, and the condition is going to be our number greater than 0. Okay, so this is going to be the condition, because I've clearly mentioned here that our number will be 0 at the end. Okay, so once our number becomes 0, we will be terminating this while loop completely. So we'll just end the while loop when our number becomes 0 at the end. So first thing, we will be extracting the last digit from our number. So for doing that, we will be having this modulus operator. So let r be our last digit, r equal to our number modulus of 10. Okay, so now let me explain you what this modulus thing does. So imagine our number to be 1 2 3 4. So if I do modulus of 10, this gives us the remainder. So 4 is the remainder over here, because 1 2 3 0 is perfectly divisible. Or let me just go with 102. This will be much more easy. Yeah, 100 is perfectly divisible by 10, but we will be having remainder as 2. So we will be having the remainder 2 over here. And if it is 122, the same thing, 120 is perfectly divisible by 10, and it just gives the remainder. So if it's 121, I'll be having here 1, and if I just have here 0, I'll just have 0. So basically, by remainder, we will be getting the last digit. So we'll be hitting this only with the help of modulus of 10, not with any other digit when we do modulus. Okay, so doing modulus of 10 gives us the remainder, which in turn becomes the last digit. Okay, so if it's 127, the remainder is going to be 7, and which is eventually the last digit. I hope that made sense. So now we are done with the first step. The second step, we need to check if that number is odd. This is like the second 2.1 step, maybe. I'll just have a if statement. Be careful with the indentation also. We need to check r modulus of 2 equality 1. Same thing, if I do 3 mod 2, that will give us the remainder as 1. Okay, because 2 is perfectly divisible by 2, we'll need to give the remainder. 1 is the remainder. Okay, so what if I go with 7? 7 modulus 2 is, the remainder is 1. And if I go with 4, which is an even number, I will be getting the remainder as 0. So basically, odd numbers when performed modulus operation with 2 will give us 1. So this is the way to check if that number is an odd or even number. Or you can just have not equal to 0 also. This is your choice. You can just have this. I'll just go with direct check. Okay, equal to 1. And what's the next step? If it's equal, we will be just finding the sum. So for finding the sum, we will be having a variable. We need to initialize to 0 so that our sum variable doesn't take a garbage or a junk value during the first iteration. So we'll just have something like sum equal to sum plus r, this last digit. Okay, we will just be adding the last digit if the last digit is an odd number, and during the first iteration this sum won't have any value, right? The sum will be just, you know, just a uninitialized variable, so it may take a garbage or junk value or even throw an error. So for that we will be just adding sum equal to 0 just for the first iteration. So it's no harm in adding 0 because any number added with 0 just gives the number itself. So you can just have sum equal to 0, and that's it. Next thing is going to be remove the last digit. So the reason why we are having this step is that we are, let me have a number as 1 2 3 4. So after a point, after getting the last digit and after finding the sum, we need to find a way to iterate each and every digit, right? We can't just be stuck with the last digit. So we need to find a way. We need to reach 3, we need to reach 2, we need to reach 1. So for that, the best solution is removing the last digit and reassigning to that number itself. So I'll just come here outside the if, inside the main while, okay, main while loop. I'll just have here number equal to number slash 10, and we need to put double slash over here because this is Python. I think single slash will give us a decimal number, so make sure that you're having double slash to get an integer or a whole number there. Yeah, so now let me explain you what this does. So imagine you're having a number as 1 2 3 4. Double slash 10 will make the number as 123. This gives us a quotient because the simple logic is that 123 times 10 will give us 1 2 3 0. So this is like the nearest number, and this is just a quotient. We are just neglecting the remainder. Okay, here we are taking the remainder, here we are just taking the quotient. So if we do 12 slash 10, this will give us 1, which is the quotient. Okay, just imagine dividing 12 by 10, we will be getting the quotient alone, and we are assigning that quotient to the number itself. And by finding this quotient, we are able to remove the last digit. That's a cool thing about this. So if I go with 123 and if I do 123 slash 10 or double slash 10, we'll be getting 12. Okay, 120 is divisible, we'll be getting the quotient as 12. So by this way, by this quotient way and assigning to the number itself, we'll be able to remove the last digit completely. And after this, the entire process just goes on. So I will just now explain this with an example. Okay, so let's begin and let's just have our input number. Let's have our input number from the user as 123. Yeah, let's just have 123. Simple. It comes here, checks this n greater than 0. Yeah, this condition is true. 123 is greater than 0. True. It goes here, r equal to 123 modulus of 10. So this gives us the last digit. So this will be 3. R value will be 3. It checks for this condition. 3 modulus of 2 is equal to 1. Condition is true because 3 is an odd number. It goes here, sum equal to sum plus r. Sum is 0 earlier, so it's going to be 0 plus r value is 3, which is 3. Sum is 3 now. At the moment, sum is 3. It goes here, n equal to n slash 10. N equal to n value is 123. Double slash 10 will give us the quotient 12. By this way, we will be removing the last digit. It again goes here, n is now 12 because we just removed the last digit. Condition is true. 12 is greater than 0. True. Now n is 12. 12 modulus of 10 will give us 2 this time. Okay, 2 because we just removed the last digit 3. So no more 3. We will be having 2. This is the remainder. It checks here 2 modulus of 2. Unfortunately, the condition is false because 2 is an even number. Nothing happens here. We won't be adding. Our sums still remains as 3. And n is 12, right? So we need to have 12 over here. And 12 double slash 10 will give us 1. 1 is the quotient. Okay, imagine dividing 12 by 10, we will be getting the quotient as 1. So by this way, we are removing 2, the last digit. We just removed last digit and we are assigning to n itself. So n is now 1. 1 modulus of 10 is 1 and it is not 0. Okay, 1 modulus of 10 is 1. It goes here, 1 modulus of 2 is also 1. So it goes here, and now sum equal to sum plus r. Our sum value is already 3. So just 3 comes here, and r value is 1. So it's going to be 3 plus 1. This is going to be 4. Our sum is going to be 4. And here n is 1. 1 double slash of 10, unfortunately, is 0. Unlike modulus, this is 0. We don't have any quotient. Okay, we can't do 1 divided by 10. It can't have a quotient. So at the end of this, remove last digit n equal to 0. As I told you, our number will be 0 at the end. It goes here, 0. This condition fails because n greater than 0, 0 greater than 0 is absolutely false. This condition fails. Everything is done. And at the end, you can just come here You need to come outside the while indentation, okay? It needs to be a separate print. You can just print sum, this variable. This variable will have 4, which is the sum of odd digits in 1, 2, 3. 1 is odd, 3 is odd, 2 is even, 1 plus 3, 4, which is the sum of odd digits. Yeah. This is the code, guys. Let me just now run and show you. I'll remove the comments. Just 10 lines, not even 10. Let me remove the 8 lines to be precise. I will save this and I will run this now. Enter a number. Let me go with our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 1, 4. We need to get 9 in the output. I'm getting 9. Let me rerun it again. Let me go with a random number. Okay. So I need to do the math now. 9, 7, and 1. It's 17. I need to get 17. Yeah, I'm getting 17. So simple. And if you want the even numbers, you can just change this to 0. Rather than having 1, you can change this to 0. That will print the sum of even numbers. And if you remove this if condition fully, that will give the sum of all digits. So 3 programs in one video. I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of tutorials in Python, C++, Node.js, MySQL, MongoDB queries, and some CRUD operations also. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.